White jerseys, gold numbers trimmed in black. Rochester go right to left, Culver left to right, and the varsity game is underway as Carly Murphy controls the tip in the backcourt for the Lady Zebras. Works to the right wing for Rochester. Again, the JV contest tonight went to Rochester over Culver 47-7. They are perfect 6-0 now as Riley Holland runs to the baseline, caught off by the defense. Now to Murphy. Murphy at the free throw line. Now backs it out behind the arc between the rings, now between the circles. Now to Holland, back outside to Hunter. Her baby hook in the lane is no good. Pollock with the rebound. The putback is no good. And the ball is saved from going out of bounds, but right into the hands of Kaylee Smith. Gives to Hunter at the free throw line. Now to Murphy in the left wing. Down low to wide open Smith. Her layup is in and out and good.
Wow.
And Tatum Schultz with the rebound. Culver runs to our right. Schultz on the right side of the wing. No look pass to Schaefer. Is between her legs out of bounds. Schaefer goes in for an uncontested layup, but that's a good pass.
Yeah, it was a good pass. Just wasn't able to handle the skip off the floor.
So first turnover of the game, go to the Lady Cavaliers.
Three-quarter court press for the Lady Cavaliers.
50 seconds gone in the opening quarter, no score. As Rochester breaks that press, as Carly Murphy has it on the right side, now swings down low, left to Hunter, outside to Hunter, Holland for three. It's no good, and the rebound is Zahner. Zahner pushes to Schultz. Schultz down low to Schaefer. Schaefer, one dribble, has a shot blocked from behind, picked up by Holland.
Great defense by the Lady Zebras. She had an easy layup on that one.
Holland picks her way through the traffic. She pulls up from 8 foot. It goes. Rochester strike first. It's 2-0. With 6:45 to play in the first quarter, the Lady Cavaliers now the basketball going to our right. Tatum Schultz runs the point. She'll walk it right through the center circle. Out of Overmeyer. One dribble, gives up the basketball now to Schultz on the left side. Schultz. Looks like Rochester running a box and one. That one
exactly
is Schaefer,
yeah.
And Smith is chasing her.
Yep.
Zahner in the corner, gives to Hardy on the baseline. Takes it back outside to Overmeyer. Now to Schaefer, top of the key. Back to Overmeyer, right side of the baseline to Hardy on the right side of the floor. A couple of dribbles behind the arc for Culver. Now to Overmeyer, quickly to Schultz. Schultz works left side behind the arc. Gives to Zahner, 15 feet away from the basket on the left side. Lobs down low to Hardy, has her pass knocked out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Hardy.
Wow.
Got to go to Rochester.
Looks like the Lady Cavaliers are a lot more comfortable in transition than they are setting up in the half court.
You're right. They got a lot of speed, you're right, and they want to use that, you can tell. And I guess that goes hand-in-hand with high-pressure defense.
Yeah, exactly.
Hunter gives to Holland. Riley runs her baseline, pulls up just inside of the arc, is no good, and Schaefer the rebound. Schaefer clears to Schultz, Culver runs to our right, ahead to Overmeyer. Overmeyer against Holland. Outside behind the arc, now to Schultz. She drives the lane, cut off by the defense, back to Overmeyer behind the arc right wing. Now on the baseline to Hardy. Hardy with B. Pollock in her jersey out to Overmeyer. Schaefer quickly slings left side to Schultz. Now on the baseline to Zahner. Zahner takes Carly Murphy to the basket, and I believe Murphy is going to pick up the blocking foul to be out of bounds to Culver baseline left. 5:27 to play, first quarter. Rochester leading 2-0. And it'll be out of bounds to Lady Cavs baseline left. And it looked like Kayla Schaefer the inbound does so to Hardy. Hardy throws a shot up over the defense. It's no good. B. Pollock rips the board and gives to Murphy. Carly runs it up the floor. Rochester up 2-0. Gives right side to Holland. Holland behind the arc on the wing. And it looks like as intense as Culver wants to play defensively, they're in a 2-3 zone.
Yeah.
Contrary to what Coach Earlmeyer told me in the pregame.
She changed her mind already.
Carly Murphy shot in the lane. Goes, and Rochester up 4-0.
And I have to say, the Lady Z's have done a pretty good job attacking that 2-3 zone. They've had a lot of good looks and got a couple buckets out of it.
Why wouldn't you play 2-3 when you know the best player plays down low? And
yeah. Yep.
And, of course, Rochester's best player right now, scoring player up to this point, is B. Pollock. Overmeyer fires a three. It's a knuckleball, and it goes. 4-3. Rochester's lead is cut to one with 4:40 to play in the first quarter. And Murphy brings the ball up the floor quickly to B. Pollock outside right. Now to Holland, near side to Murphy. Murph at the free throw line to Smith. Back to Murphy, right side to Holland behind the arc on the right side. Pushes away in the lane, gives to Murphy on behind the arc left side, feeds down low to Hunter. Rand backs her way in, kicks it out to Smith, now to Holland, top of the key, three on the way for the Lady Zebras, goes!
Riley Holland with her fifth point of this first quarter.
7-3, Rochester back on top by four with 4:10 to play in the first quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We're at Rochester High School. As Overmeyer looks at the three, passes it up, gives to Harding the right baseline. Now she dribbles behind the arc, down to Zahner on the right baseline, 15 feet away from the basket. She works against Carly Murphy. She steps back for a three. It's no good, too hard. And the long rebound comes down to Schaefer. Schaefer behind the arc. Now to Overmeyer, right wing. She'll fire a three right in B. Pollock's face. His shot's no good. And the ball is going to go out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by the Lady Zebras, and it'll stay with the Cavaliers. A 3:45 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up again 7-3.
The Lady Z's may need to extend that zone out a little bit on Overmeyer. She's hit one three, and she's looked at two more. So
Culver has it after the out-of-bounds play. Overmeyer has it. Bounce pass down low to Zahner. She loses the ball on the floor, picked up by Pollock, and now to Carly Murphy. Rochester up by four with 3.5 to play in the first quarter. Murphy walks to the center circle, works to the right wing. Behind the arc against the 2-3 zone. Picks up her dribble, gives to Hunter top of the key, lobs down low to Pollock. Beat Pollock over Schaefer, it's good. 9-3 Rochester, 3:15 to play in the first quarter. Schultz down low to Hardy. Hardy against Hunter. Throws a prayer up, it's no good. Zahner with a rebound, the putback is no good, and Beat Pollock rips the board. Down to Murphy. Rochester runs to our left. Up 9-3, under 3 minutes to play in the first quarter. Murphy dribbles her way down low, gives it to Pollock. She throws up a shot, it's good. Against a double team, Brad.
As I say, good job by Pollock. The Lady Cavs did everything right. They even brought the help side defense on the lob pass, and she was still able to get it in.
Pollock, I believe, has four now, and it's 11-3, Rochester.
Yep.
With 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Schultz has it behind the arc, now in the lane, kicks it outside to Zahner. Zahner gives right side to Schaefer. She'll fire a three right to the mug of Smith. It goes. How nice of an asset is that? 5'10 can play down low, or she can take her game outside and bury a three like she just did.
Yeah, well, keep the game close all night if that keeps on.
Rochester's lead's cut to five. Holland in the lane, and her pass is taken away by Taylor Schaefer. Now gives to Schultz. 11-6 Rochester, 2 minutes to play, first quarter. Now to Overmeyer, right side, another three on the way for the Lady Cavs. Is off the mark, no good. Schaefer crashes the board offensively, back to Overmeyer. Overmeyer now to Schultz, top of the key, in the paint, gives down low to Hardy. Her jumper on the window goes. How about that nice ball movement by the Lady Cavs? And it's 11-8 all of a sudden. Minute 45 to play in the first quarter. Rochester up by three, 11-8. And now the man-to-man defense by the Lady Cavs. Murphy around the defense on the pick and roll, out to Hunter, top of the key, right side to Holland. Riley holds the ball above her head, now works to the top, switches directions, works to the right side. Against Schultz. Now to Smith. Smith gets a pick. She takes the basketball into the lane, throws it away, right into the hands of Schaefer. Taylor Schaefer goes left side. Her left-handed layup is on the way. It's good. And all of a sudden, this what was their 9-point lead has been cut to one. It's 11-10 Rochester with a minute 10 to play in the first quarter.
Smith trying to force it the last time down low to Pollock. She was double-teamed.
No look pass to Hunter. Off her fingertips into the hands of Overmeyer. Culver runs the other way after the Rochester turnover. Quickly to Schaefer. Left-handed layup, no good, but Riley Holland going to pick up a foul. And Kayla Schaefer for the Lady Cavs will go to the line to shoot two.
White, one. Number 10, Riley Holland at the line.
Kayla Schaefer, the 5'10 junior, the line for two for her Lady Cavs. The first one's on the way, and it gets good, and we're tied at 11. I believe it's 11-3 at one point. Yes?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And now Lady Cavs on an 8-0 run, make it a 9-0 run as Schaefer hits both, and now for the first time tonight, the Lady Cavs lead. It's 12-11. Culver with under a minute to play in the first quarter here at Rochester High School. Riley Holland against a double team. Picks up a dribble, gives to Smith in the lane. Down low to Hunter, outside to Riley Holland. Quick three, left wing. Nope. Off the mark. Zahner clears the board, gives it to Schultz. Now ahead to Schaefer. Schaefer then makes that Schultz's pass. Sipped out of bounds by Riley Holland. And it'll stay with the Lady Cavs baseline right. 42 seconds to play in the first quarter. Lady Cavs up by one. Schaefer will look to trigger it in baseline right. Will look to do so around Smith. Does so to Zahner. Now top two, Schultz. Schultz holds on the right wing. Back to Schaefer on the right baseline. She throws up a shot. It's no good. Murphy with a rebound. Murph brings it up the floor with under 30 seconds to play. First quarter, Rochester down by a point at 12-11. And Murphy works to the right wing against Overmeyer in the man-to-man defense. Top to Holland. Riley studies with 20. Riley back door to Murphy. Murphy almost travels, throws the ball away right to the hands of Donna Zahner. Now head to Schultz at 10. Tatum Schultz right side with 9. Throws up a shot over B. Pollock. It's no good, but more importantly for the Lady Cavs, B. Pollock has just picked up a foul.
She picks up her first one. That's the team third.
So Tatum Schultz will go to the line to shoot 2. 8.5 seconds to play in the first quarter. I'm extremely impressed with the team speed of the Culver's shooting right now.
Yeah, I mean, that's one of their strong points of their ball game is to get out and run.
Schultz misses the first free throw. She'll have one more. It's 12-11 Culver with 8.5 seconds to play in the first quarter. And Schultz at the line for one more. Second one is good this time. 13-11 Culver, 8 seconds to play in the opening quarter. Holland crosses the timeline with 4. Jump pass to Hunter with 3. Hunter for 3, left side, off the side of the backboard, no good. The put back by Holland is no good. And that comes, the first quarter comes to an end. After 1, the Lady Cavs lead 13-10. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
It's not how you start, but how you finish. At Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram of Winnemac, we want you to finish big with the Big Finish 2012. There's still time for huge savings on 2012 models. And come check out our lineup of impressive new 2013 vehicles arriving daily, including the technologically advanced Chrysler 300, impressive Dodge Dart, and rugged Jeeps and Rams. Take advantage of the Big Finish 2012 at Braun Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram, US 35 South in Winnemac, online at BraunChryslerDodgeJeep.com.
Jennings Insurance, your professional Pekin Insurance agency located in Argus and Rochester, believes in the game of life and pays to make sure you're safely covered with insurance. They can help you cover all the bases, whether it's auto, homeowners, life, business, health, or an annuity. At Jennings Insurance, they'll help you compare rates and prices. That's Jennings Insurance and Pekin teaming up to help you plan ahead for protection against those unexpected plays in the game of life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Rochester High School, we go to the second quarter as the first quarter ends. Brad Culver into the first period on a 10-0 run.
Yeah, they did, and you can credit Kayla Schaefer with 7 of those 10 points on that run, and she's really picked up her whole team.
Cavaliers lead 13-11, and they start the second quarter of the basketball going to our right. Rochester in a box of one still, isn't it?
Yes.
No, I don't think so. Yeah, it is. Now
they just switched. They put Murphy.
They put Murphy on Zahner.
Yeah, move Pollock over on Schaefer.
No, it isn't. It's a triangle and 2.
Okay.
Overmeyer for 3 over Mitchell's. Knuckleball again. No good. Hardy the rebound. Offensive board. Works against Pfeiffer. Throws the shot up a glass. It goes. It's a triangle and 2, and Rochester's chasing Schaefer and Zahner. 15-11. Culver now on a 12-0 run. 7:15 to play in the first half. Murphy high on the left side for Rochester. Down low to Pollock. Pollock's been quiet now against the double team. Gives to Holland. Riley at the free throw line. Cross court to Murphy. Out to make that Mitchell out to Murphy. 7 minutes to play in the first half. Murph backs it out. Sets up the offense again for Rochester. Looks like Culver in that man-to-man defense. Bounce pass right wing to Holland. Riley gets a pick from B. Pollock. Throws up a shot in the paint. No good. And the rebound to Hardy. Gives to Schultz. Culver runs. Near side to Overmeyer. Overmeyer looking down low to Zahner. Can't find her now. Housing the baseline behind the arc. Outside to Zahner. To Schultz. Now Schaefer. Schaefer now to Tatum Schultz. High on the left side. 3 sets for Culver. Gives to Hardy on the right baseline. The give and go. Schaefer goes to the basket. Good. A foul. We're watching a pretty good team.
Yeah.
The ball movement is remarkable right now for the Lady Cavaliers. Nobody holds it very long.
Yep. B. Pollock picks up her second foul. So she won't be on the floor very long, I would guess. You're right. The Lady Cavs have definitely improved their ball movement here at the beginning of the second quarter.
Schaefer completes a 3-point play with a freebie. And the score is 18-11. Culver with 6:25 to play in the first half. And the freshman duo coming in, that being X Holland and Becky Malko. Lob over the pass to Holland. Holland takes it to the baseline. Pull up 10-footer is no good. And the rebound to Schaefer, who loses the basketball. Pollock picks it up, and she is fouled by Schultz. So that's Culver's first team foul with 6 minutes to play in the first half. going to be Rochester basketball out of bounds baseline left as Malco and Alexa Holland will come in for the first time tonight for Rochester. And they will replace B. Pollock, like Brad said, has two personals. Nope, I beg your pardon, it'll be Mitchell and Murphy.
And number 24, Alexa
Holland. So B comes out, Murphy comes out, Mitchell stays. Confusing? Indeed.
Yeah.
I think if you were watching it, it doesn't get any clearer. Holland gets it into sister Alexa. Alexa around the defense. Gives to Mitchell at the free throw line. One dribble to Becky Malco. Hesitates. Accelerates to the basket. Throws the shot up of a window. No good. And the rebound to Schultz, and Culver runs. Schultz on the right side of the floor. Hesitates. Around Holland to the glass. Layup is good.
And right now, that's where the Lady Z's got to find some help on the defensive side of the ball.
Rochester uses a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Being a parent has never been tougher. Life just offers too many choices and temptations. Many families find help by becoming affiliated with Friends at their place of worship, and that is a great help. If you find your life is offering more questions than answers, why not join us at Grace United Methodist Church? We have services on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Child care is provided at both services. Our church is located at 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester. We welcome you to become a part of our church family.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Rochester trying to stop this 17-0 run put on by the Lady Cavaliers. It's 20-11. Lady Cavs with 5:46 to play in the first half. At one point, Brad, Rochester led 11-3 midway through the first quarter.
With about 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, and it's been all Cavaliers since.
We don't keep track of this, but I would love to see what the number is on transition buckets. They are so fast.
Yeah, I could all... Just watching what we've watched so far, you could almost bet that all of them, but about two, have been transitioned.
They're not as crisp as they're in the set offense formation, but boy, when they get out and run, and they can all run, 5'10", 5', it doesn't matter. They can all run.
Yeah.
So on the turnover, Culver gets it back. Schultz around the defense, kicks it in the corner to Overmeyer, who fires a three. It's no good. And the rebound fought for, and Becky Malco comes out of there with it. Malco, right side of the floor, loses the handle. Picked up by Zahner. Now ahead to Schultz. Tatum Schultz, left side of the floor. She goes coast to coast. Throws up a shot, no good. And the ball is going to be tipped out of bounds by Heck Holland. I think that's a good call. And it'll stay with Culver on the near side right in front of the Rochester bench.
I thought that was a good call.
You know, Schaefer swatted at it.
Yeah.
And it knocked off the hands of X Holland. Schaefer looks to get it in, right side, now to Overmeyer. Overmeyer high on the right side for the Lady Cavaliers in the corner to Llewellyn, who's newly into the basketball game, to Schultz left wing. Schultz down low to Zahner, throws up a shot quickly on the glass, no good. The rebound putback is no good. Schaefer the rebound. Her left-handed putback is on the way. It's no good. And Riley Holland clears the board. Three-point blank shots right there by Culver. Couldn't get him to go. Down low to Pfeiffer. Riley throws a shot up, no good, but a foul coming on Donna Zahner, and that's going to send Pfeiffer to the line for two for Rochester.
It'll be Zahner's first team second.
4:44 to play in the first half. Rochester down by 9 at 20-11, and Riley Pfeiffer, the sophomore, at the line for two for her Lady Z's. Riley's right-handed free throw is good. She'll have one more as Kaylee Smith will come back into the game. And Smith will replace Lindsay Mitchell for the Rochester Lady Zebras. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. A fury of action here in the last about 5 minutes. Basically for Culver.
That's like the first points for Rochester in almost 6 minutes.
That snaps a 17-0 run. Free throw is good by Pfeiffer. She makes both, and it's 20-13. Schultz with the basketball, and she double dribbles. Yep. Good turnover. Good job by the Rochester Lady Zebras. Created that turnover.
Yeah, that's something else that took place during that run, too, was the Lady Cavaliers turned the ball over four times in the first couple of minutes of the game, and then that was their first turnover since.
So, obviously, running really suits them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Riley Holland high on the right side against Tatum Schultz. Works left side. Gets a phantom pick from Kaylee Smith. Now to Becky Malco. Malco on the left wing. Now to X Holland. Alexa fakes the three around Llewellyn. Now pulls it back out behind the arc. Sets up the offense for Rochester. Between the legs, dribble at the free throw line. Out to Holland. Malco. Bounce pass is taken away by Tatum Schultz. Schultz left side of the floor. 1-on-3 break, and she is fouled going to the basket by either Alexa or Riley Holland. Wait and see who that's going to be whistled against. That's Riley. It's number two on Riley.
Team fifth.
4:08 to play in the first half as Rayan Hunter comes back into the game. And coming out is Riley Holland. 20-13 Culver. Again, 4:08 to play in the first half. And what I didn't get to in the pregame show, Coach Hurlmeyer is going for her 100th victory tonight.
Oh, wow.
Baby hook in the lane is no good. Hunter clears the board and gives to X. Holland runs to our left. Holland goes over the basket, throws up a shot, partially blocked. Tatum Schultz picks up the rebound. Now head to Schaefer. Kayla Schaefer goes to the basket. Layup is good. And Culver's lead is out to 9 at 22-13 with 3:45 to play in the first half.
That's Schaefer's 12th point.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Hunter quickly to Smith. Loses the handle. Picked up by Rayan Hunter. Against Schultz, now outside to Holland. Alexa Holland, the freshman in the game for Rochester. Riley on the bench with two personal fouls. Alexa picks the ball up. Now to Smith. Kaylee, bounce pass back to the near side to Holland. Back door to Hunter. Hunter loses the handle, throws up a shot. She's going to be fouled on the shot, and she'll go to the line to shoot two. So Rayan Hunter, one of the two seniors to the Lady Zebras, will go to the line to shoot two free throws for Rochester with 3:21 to play in the first half. Rochester down by 9.
That'll be Donna Zahner's second foul for the Lady Cavs.
That's one thing we talked about in the pregame as well with Coach Hurlmeyer about the foul situation. They're not very deep. And they only have 3 team fouls. Unfortunately, Donna Zahner for Culver with both of them, or with two of the three. Hardy comes in for her. Shakira Harris comes in for the first time tonight. She replaces Overmeyer for the Lady Cavs. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Zahner didn't score any points in those first couple quarters, but she did take a lot of pressure off of Schaefer to where she was able to score points.
Hunter misses a free throw. The rebound to Smith, who kicks it back to X Holland, and it goes for 3. 22-16. The Wellen with the basketball high on the right side to Schultz. 3 minutes to play, first half. Coming up at halftime, we'll talk to junior varsity coach Randy Wynn about their big win tonight, 47-7 over the Lady Cavaliers. Hardy with the basketball. Now to the Wellen, outside left. Now here's the set offense that doesn't look as smooth as the transition offense for Culver.
You're right.
The Wellen on the baseline, cut off by Becky Malko, outside to Harris. Harris, a couple of dribbles to the free throw line. Gives outside to Schultz, who's guarded tightly by Holland. Alexa Holland, that is. Now to Schaefer. Schaefer stands about 5 feet behind the arc on the right wing. Passes back to Schultz at the volleyball line between the rings. 22-16 Culver. Cut off by the defense. Ball tipped away on the pass and picked up by Holland.
It's almost that they have an internal clock that runs in their head that if they don't score right away, it starts to frustrate them. Yeah.
Rochester down by 6. And Malco throws the ball right into the hands of Culver and Schultz. He'll look past to Hardy. Hardy shot over Piper. It goes. And it's back to an 8-point lead in favor of Culver with under 2 minutes to play in the first half. Holland, another 3 right side is short. Rebound is tipped out of bounds by Piper. And Culver going to get it back. Again, Holland and B. Pollock both with 2 personal fouls in this first half as the second quarter winding down. Minute 45 to play in the second quarter. Culver up by 8 as Harris dribbles to Schultz between the rings. Now right wing to Llewellyn behind the arc. Llewellyn over the defense to Harris on the left side. In the paint, cut off by the defense outside of Llewellyn. Crossover dribble, takes Malco to the paint, gives to Hardy on the right baseline. Hardy against Hunter, backs away in the paint, throws up a shot over the defense. It's no good, ball tipped out on the rebound, and Schultz comes out of there with it, and she travels. You're right, though.
Yeah, it seems like the longer it takes them to score, the more frustrated they get.
It's almost like mass confusion, even though most of the starters are still on the floor for Culver.
I agree. Yeah. They definitely like to get the transition bucket or within the first 2 or 3 passes.
1:10 to play in the first half. Culver up 24-16. It'll be Rochester basketball going to our left. Hunter at the free throw line. Kicks it out to Murphy, who's back into the game. Down low to Piper. Riley. has their shot knocked out of bounds. I'm not sure how that wasn't a tie-up if it wasn't a foul, but the shot is knocked out of bounds by Schultz. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. Riley Holland looks to get it in. Riley over the defense to Murphy with a minute to play in the first half. Back to Holland left side. Holland around the pick, pulls up from 15 feet. It's good. That's what Coach Perlmeyer is screaming about. That's an illegal screen. No call, and Rochester takes advantage of the illegal screen and cuts the lead to six.
It's only illegal if they call it.
It wasn't illegal then. Schultz on the right side. Out of Harris. Fakes a three. Drives in the paint. Ball is being tipped around down low. Llewellyn and the Lady Cavs with the basketball. Back to Schultz with 30 seconds. Wrap around pass down low to Hardy. Hardy in the paint. Kicks it out to Llewellyn. Llewellyn runs the baseline, and her shot is tipped out of bounds. Last touch by Rochester. It'll stay with Lady Cavaliers. Baseline left with 22 seconds to play in the first quarter. Alexa Holland will come back into the game, and Riley will sit. 24-18 Culver with 22 seconds to play in the first half. Shakira Harris will look to get it in. Baseline left for her Lady Cavs. Harris studies. Gets it into Schultz in the left corner. One dribble to Hardy. She'll take the 10-footer. Short. Draws nothing but air. Holland picks it up with 15. X runs hard to our left with 12. Holland left side with 10. Now dribbles to the middle of the floor with 8. To Smith on the left wing with 5. Kayla Smith with 2. Murphy then with 1. Her jumper is no good. The putback by Hunter at the buzzer is no good. At halftime, Culver leads 24-18. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI. For Rochester, 6 for the Lady Cavs. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. We're ready for the third quarter, and Rochester will start with the basketball. On the floor for the Lady Cavs, the original starters, Zahner, Hardy, Schultz, Schaefer, and Overmeyer. On the floor for Rochester, their original five, Pollock, Hunter, Holland. I beg your pardon, that's not right, the original five. As Kaylee Smith didn't come out, but Alexa Holland is staying on. Murphy and Riley Holland.
Both Riley Holland and Bree Pollock with 2 fouls, as well as Donna Zahner for the Lady Cavs.
1-2-2 zone for the Lady Cavs.
Yep.
Alexa Holland over the defense to Riley. Down
trapping
low to
zone.
Hunter to Murphy. Now to X. Lob pass down low to Pollock against the triple team. Somehow gets a shot up. It's no good. And the ball comes out of there to Hunter. Now to Holland, to Pollock. Her jumper's no good, but a foul coming on Culver, and I believe that's going to be on Zahner. And that's if that's the case, that's number 3 on Donna Zahner. And more importantly, Rochester working extremely hard to get B. Pollock the basketball.
Yeah, they are.
And she'll go to the line to shoot, too, as she was fouled on the shot.
B. Pollock.
B's free throw is good. How many does she have in the first half?
She had 4 in the first quarter. Battle foul trouble in the second quarter.
Right.
And give some credit to the Lady Cavs defense. They've been pretty effective in keeping her neutralized.
But I think that was their main objective, as it will be for most teams coming into Rochester.
Yeah.
Angela Llewellyn, the 5'3 sophomore, back into the game, and Donna Zahner will sit again with 3 personal fouls. As B. Pollock will have 1 more for Rochester. Second on the way is good as it rattles home. And the lead is cut to 4 at 24-20. Early into the second half. Llewellyn runs the point right through the center circle for the Lady Cavs. Stands at the top of the key, high on the right side to Overmeyer. Triangle and 2, defense again for Rochester. Schultz outside to Llewellyn. Cut off, her 15-footer is no good. And the rebound is taken by Hunter. Now to Murphy to Riley Holland, runs to our right to the Lady Zebras. Riley Holland on the right side, just switches directions, bounce pass to Murphy at the free throw line, down low to Pollock. B against the double team, out to X. Alexa Holland out to Murphy. Murphy, 1 dribble, passes left side to Holland. Riley, that is, dumps that pass down low to Hunter. Step back, 15-footer is no good. And the rebound to Schaefer. Schaefer now ahead to Overmeyer on the right side. Overmeyer out to Schultz. Swings near side to Llewellyn. Down the left corner to Schaefer. She'll fire a quick 3. Left side's no good. Long rebound to Pollock. Nice block out by Pollock, who cleared Schultz and grabbed the board. Alexa Holland dribbles in the left wing. Passes to X, or make that Riley in the corner. Now to Murphy at the top of the key. Murph, 1 dribble at the free throw line. Just pass to Alexa Holland, who works right side. Dump pass down low to Pollock. B. get past to Riley Holland. Her 10-footer from the baseline is good.
It was a good decision by Pollock to find Holland in the, on the baseline because she was pretty well covered underneath.
Well, if three people are on you, somebody else are open.
Exactly.
24-22. The lead is cut to four. I'm sorry, cut to two with 6 minutes to play in the third quarter. Hardy stands behind the wing arc on the left wing. Now to Overmeyer on the right side. Couple of dribbles. Bounce pass to Schaefer high on the right side. Cross court left to Llewellyn. Llewellyn, top of the key to Overmeyer. Oh, she passed up a wide open three to Schaefer on the right side. Looking back door to Schultz. Ball tipped away and into the hands of Riley Holland. Holland right side of the floor. Goes to the basket for the tie. Throws up a shot. No good, but a blocking foul coming on Overmeyer. And that's going to send Riley Holland to the line for two. Looking to tie this game up at 24.
The Overmeyer's first.
Number 20. Allie Overmeyer, shooting two for the Zebras, number 10, Riley Holland.
5:41 to play in the third quarter. Riley Holland at the line for two. First one is up and good as it hits the back of the rim, bounces up and falls through. She'll have one more looking to tie this thing up at 24. A six-point spread at the break, and the free throw's off the mark. Be Holland, the rebound, the putback is good.
Nice job by Pollock.
Rochester goes from being down to being up by one at 25-24. Llewellyn gives right side to Overmeyer. Now in the corner to Hardy. Back to Overmeyer, swings the left side to Llewellyn, dribbles to the left side to Schaefer. Schaefer in the corner, has a ball picked off by Alexa Holland, and gives to Riley Holland. Rochester runs up by one. Riley Holland left wing, bounce pass down low to B. Pollock and out of bounds, and it'll go back to Culver. Nice idea, but B. Pollock didn't pop out. And so back into the game is Zahner. Didn't two sit down?
No.
Oh,
they're standing on the sideline there. Yeah.
So Zahner back into the game. And Hardy sits. 5:10 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by one at 25-24. Zahner to Schaefer at the free throw line. I think she about double dribbled.
I think she did too.
To the Llewellyn. Now to Zahner behind the arc left side. She studies the Schultz. Tatum Schultz looks back door to Zahner, throws in the first throw of the band, and Rochester will get it back after another Culver turnover, up 25-24 with under five to play in the third quarter. Alexa Holland outruns the point for Rochester. It looks like Lady Cavs in the man-to-man defense. Holland high on the left side for Rochester, dumps down low to Hunter. Hunter, baby hook in the lane, is good. Rochester extends the lead to three at 27-24 with 4.5 to play in the third. Rochester on a 9-0 run here to start the third quarter.
Mm-hmm.
Schaefer backs away in the lane, cut off by the double team, loses the handle, picks the dribble back up. Now to Schultz. Back to Overmeyer, who runs the point top for Culver. Now to Llewellyn. Llewellyn left wing. Gives to Schaefer. She'll take the jumper from above the free throw line. It's no good. And Alexa Holland with the basketball now after the rebound by Pollock. 4 minutes to play in the third. Rochester up by three at 27-24. Riley top of the key. Fakes a three. Drives around the defense. And we're going to have an illegal screen down low, I believe, on Hunter. And Rochester's going to turn the ball over and give it back to Culver as they are up by three with 3:56 to play in the third quarter.
Hunter and Zahner getting into a pushing match down low. That time down the floor, Hunter got called with the foul. That's her first.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Rochester High School non-conference basketball game here this evening as Rochester leading number 14, Culver, 27-24. Overmeyer gives to Schaefer. Down the corner to Zahner. Zahner fakes a shot, drives around Hunter, cut off by the B. Pollock defense. Out to Overmeyer for three. Right side is good, and we're tied at 27. Has a quick catch and shoot by Overmeyer, and we're tied at 27.
It's her second three of the ball game.
B. Pollock over the against Zahner down low to Holland. X around the defense on the elbow. Outside to Murphy. Murph, couple of dribbles. Looks to dump down low. Good defense. They had Schultz behind and Zahner in front. And B. Pollock just got away with the third foul there.
Yes.
As she nailed Zahner right in the nose.
Swat at the ball, but Zahner moved the ball and Pollock hit her in the nose.
So Culver will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC's FiberConnect is the leading scorer in the world of communications. Let RTC give you the safety of knowing you have touched down with a real winner when you sign up for cable television, high-speed internet, and telephone services. Don't pass this opportunity up and don't get blitzed by the competition. Cheer on the hometown team and call RTC at 223-2191 in Rochester or 598-2782 in Akron.
Call RTC in Rochester or Akron and become an eligible receiver for their winning FiberConnect services.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3 minutes, 3 seconds to play in the third quarter. We're tied at 27. The 9-0 run broken by the three by Overmeyer on the right side of the floor.
Right, yeah, the Lady Zebras had a good start to that third quarter. Now let's see how they answer after the timeout.
So Culver takes the timeout. They'll have the basketball underneath their own basket baseline left. Schaefer gets into Llewellyn in the left corner. Dribbles to the wing. Now at the volleyball line between the rings. Now left side to Schaefer. Back to Schultz. Schultz throws up a shot in the lane. It's no good off the mark. And B. Pollock rips the board. Nice block out by Riley Holland.
Yeah, it was. She was able to clear that space out for Pollock to get up and get the rebound.
Bounce pass to X on the right wing. Alexa works left side of the floor. Lobs pass down low to Hunter. Her jumper is good off the glass. I tell you what, Rayan Hunter needs to be careful pushing off of that offhand. Could you go get that pass? That could have been easily offensive pass interference. That could have easily been offensive foul.
That too.
Schaefer, 15-footer left baseline goes. Nice teardrop shot by Kayla Schaefer. We're tied at 29.
Been quiet for a little while there, second half of the second quarter. But he's got 14 now.
Pollock saves the basketball from going out of bounds. Ball's loose still. She picks it up from Murphy's hand. Now gives the X left side. Alexa with the basketball. Lob down low to Hunter. Her jumper on the glass. A good and a foul.
Hunter with her sixth point in this quarter.
Rochester up 31-29, and Rayan Hunter will go to the line to shoot one free throw to try to complete the three-point play. And Smith comes back into the game, and Murphy sits down. Hardy back in. Zahner sits. Also back in is Harris, and Schaefer will sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
And
Rochester up here at Rochester High School with 2 minutes to play in the third quarter, 31-29. And Rayan Hunter at the line to shoot one for Lady Z's. It's on the way. It's no good. The hard rebound comes to Hardy for Culver. Now to Schultz. Schultz to Harris on the left wing. To a cutting Hardy behind her. Loose ball picked up by Pollock. Now to Riley Holland. To X on the right side. Looks at the three.
She wants to
well, and she does. In the paint, her floater on the way is good. Nice looking drive by the freshman, and she gets it to go. Rochester back up by four, 33-24, the minute 35 to play in the third.
Yeah, I believe Mr. Wynn's going to lose Alexa Holland for a while. I think he will, too. She's starting to more and more prove her worth here at the varsity level.
Well, how many freshmen do you see as Hardy shoots a long shot? No good. Nice block out by Holland. And she blocked out so well that Schultz had to come over the back, try to get the ball in and fouled Holland.
That'll be Schultz's second.
To finish that thought, X Holland, even though she has a nine beside her name, is playing like a seasoned veteran.
Oh, yeah. She has no hesitation to drive the paint in there with the big girls. She'll stand out there with the confidence to pop the three-pointer when she's open.
So Tatum Schultz comes out of the game after she picked up foul number two, and Schaefer comes back in. Again, Rochester up 33-29 with a 1:10 to play in the third. Riley Holland against Harris. Takes her to the paint. Stops. Dumps down low to B. Pollock. B against Schaefer. And then we're going to travel on B. Pollock. Nice defense. It's one-on-one defense down low, man-to-man on by Schaefer, and Pollock couldn't get a shot. Minute four to play in the third. Rochester by four. Lady Cavs with the basketball. And Schaefer will cross the timeline left. She'll be picked up by Holland. Now to Harris. The top to Llewellyn. Back right side to Overmeyer behind the arc right side. Down low to Hardy. Hardy then is fouled as she goes to the basket. Is that going to be on Piper?
It's going to be on Pollock.
Pollock? Oh. I didn't think she would look like she was close to the ball.
I think her caller contact from behind. So that'll be her third, and she'll come out of the game.
Hunter comes back in. Murphy will come back in. And like Brad said, Pollock will sit, and Riley Piper will sit for Rochester. 50.7 to play in the third. Rochester up 33-29. Harris will look to get it in. looking to get it in. Still looking to get it in. The pass is tipped from coming inbounds, and Riley Holland tips it out of bounds, and it'll stay with Culver baseline right. Perlmeyer not happy with the way the girls performed that out-of-bound play. Harris looks to get it in again. Harris to Hardy in the paint. Her five-footer off the glass is no good, and the rebound is Schaefer. Schaefer dribbles out and sets up the offense for the Lady Cavs. Down low to Hardy against Hunter. Hardy cut off by the defense. Now back door to Schaefer. Her layup is off the bottom of the backboard. No good. And Riley Holland with the board. 30 seconds of play in the third quarter. Riley across the timeline. Ooh, to X.
That was pretty close.
That was close to over and back.
Yeah, it was.
Alexa Holland works right side to Riley with 20. Riley Holland between the circles with 19. The pass down low to Smith. Her jumper on the glass is good. 35-29, Rochester with 10 seconds. Llewellyn across the timeline with 9. Picks up the dribble to Overmeyer with 7. Overmeyer back to Llewellyn with 5. Llewellyn around the defense with 4. Throws up a shot, no good. Rebound to Murphy. And time's going to expire in the third. After 3, Rochester leading 35-29. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's tables since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Why do people love Nubiano's famous Italian pizza so much?
It makes me happy.
The gooey cheese.
The hand-tossed crust.
The toppings. The homemade sauce.
The taste.
I don't know. I just love it.
Call Nubiano's at 223-4224. That's 223-4224. Dine in, carry out, and delivery is available. Don't forget, they also have delicious hot baked sandwiches and salads, too. Nubiano's Italian Pizza, 714 East 9th Street, Rochester. A Fulton County tradition since 1982.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth and final quarter we go. The Lady Zebras leading 29. And Culver will start the fourth and final quarter of the basketball. An interesting stat as you gave me off the air.
Yeah, the Lady Zebras outscored the Lady Cavs in that quarter 17-5. So
at halftime,
yeah, making up for that first quarter,
yeah,
second quarter drought that they had.
So Zahner back on the floor for the Cavs, playing with two fouls. Schultz back on the floor for the Cavaliers, playing with two personals. Llewellyn on top of the key, just inside the arc. Her jumper's no good off the mark. Ball tipped around. She comes out of there with it, and Murphy's going to pick up a foul from reaching in from behind. And neither, really, Brad, neither team is in danger of shooting free throws. Close to shooting free throws.
No.
35-29 Rochester, 7:45 to play in the game. Schaefer against Riley Holland in the corner to Llewellyn on the right wing. Llewellyn feeds down low, and then her pass is kicked away by Murphy, and it'll stay with Culver out of bounds, baseline right.
Neither team close to being in the bonus, but Donna Zahner with 3 for the Lady Cavs and Brianne Pollock with 3
right
for the Lady Zebras.
B is not in the game right now. Llewellyn's 18-footer is good as it hits none of it at the bottom of the net. And the lead is cut to 4 with 7.5 to play in the basketball game. Rochester up by 4 in the three-quarter court press we saw earlier in the game. For Culver, didn't do anything but really slowed down things. Rochester breaks it easily. Murphy outside to Holland. Down low to Smith. Jumper's no good. Rebound tipped around, and Tatum Schultz loses it off her leg and out of bounds. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. Smith has got to finish that.
Yeah, she does. Use the glass.
Riley Holland looks to inbound at baseline left. Riley studies over the defense to Alexa Holland. Now to Riley in the corner. Riley around the defense in the paint. Throws up a shot on the window off the glass. Is no good. And it's tipped out of bounds. They're going to say last touched off the face of Hardy. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. Riley Holland look to get it in again, baseline left. 7:09 to play in the game. Rochester up by 4, 35-31. Smith in the corner to X. Step back 3. Nope. And Riley with a rebound. Riley's fouled in the lane. And if that's going to be on Schultz, that's going to be foul number 3 on Tatum.
Number
7:02 to play in the game. Rochester up 35-31. Riley Holland looks to get it in again. Does so in the corner. Actually stolen away by Zahner. Zahner with those big long arms has reached down and grabbed it, and then Schaefer on the breakaway layup is good. Nice feed by Schultz, and the lead is cut to two at 35-33.
And again, they're back to their transition basketball.
That's where they score the most points, that's for sure.
Calls the turnover and get down the floor in a hurry.
Alexa Holland, cross court to sister Riley, and has the pass knocked away by Schaefer. Fortunately for Rochester, it goes out of bounds.
Schaefer's been at the other end.
Yeah. Yep. Dee Pollock back into the game. Becky Malko back into the game. And Kaylee Smith sits along with Alexa Holland. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 6:39 to play in the game. Rochester up by two at 35-33. Murphy looks to get it in. Got to hurry. Gets it into Malko. Malko around the defense. She's fouled on the shot by Hardy. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Hardy's going to pick up her first, team six.
That was a pretty violent block by Hardy, which is probably why, whether she hit the ball or hit the
hand came forward in the swat motion, and that's usually a good indication.
So Malko, another freshman for Rochester, the line for two, fires the first one. It's good. And a lead back to three, 6:35 to play in the game. Rochester up 36-33. One more coming for the freshman.
A couple of fouls by the Lady Cavs, and the Lady Zebras are on the brink of being in the bonus.
Second one is good by the freshman, Becky Malko. And it's back to a four-point lead, 37-33. Llewellyn brings it up the floor, throws it through the center circle for the Lady Cavs. Works to the near side to Schaefer, now in the corner to Schultz. Schultz takes a rare shot, no good. And the ball is saved from going out of bounds by Hardy into the hands of Schultz outside of Llewellyn. She takes a 15-footer left side, no good, and the rebound to Hunter. And Rayan Hunter now gives to Riley Holland. Nice save by Hardy. This guy hit the ceiling, but it's a nice save. And
volleyball save.
Murphy high on the left side, dribbles around Zahner, who has three personal fouls. Now to Holland. Riley sees him going out of bounds, right into the hands of Donna Zahner. Now to quickly to Schultz. Culver runs the other way. No look pass down court to Schaefer. Tipped away by Murphy. And Murphy can't save from going out of bounds. It'll stay with the Lady Cavs right in front of their own bench. That could have been ugly. As Schaefer and Malko and Murphy were all going right full head of steam right in front of the bench.
I give them credit. They all didn't run and hide.
I would have.
Yeah.
Overmeyer looks to get it in. 5:49 to play in the game. Rochester up by four, 37-33. Schultz in the corner to Schaefer. Schaefer, three from the left wing. Good. 37-36. Culver's cut into this Rochester lead. Is down to one now.
19 now for Schaefer.
That's a quiet 19, I'd say.
Absolutely.
Murphy then is fouled by Schaefer on the reach-in. And as soon as I say nobody's going to shoot free throws, Rochester is all of a sudden.
They're in the bonus. Schaefer picks up her second.
So Carly Murphy at the line to shoot one in the bonus for Rochester, who lead 37-36 with 5.5 minutes to play in the game. Riley Pfeiffer will come back into the game, and Riley will replace Rayanne Hunter for the Rochester Lady Zebras.
Again, if this keeps up, Coach Stasiak is going to achieve one of his main goals of every ball game,
which is
shoot more free throws than your opponent attempts.
Murphy collects on her first one. She'll have one more, looking to push this lead back to three. Again, with 5.5 minutes to play in the game, Murphy's second one's good again. 39-36, Rochester on top. Tatum Schultz works against Becky Malko in the backcourt. Schultz around the defense, works to the left side. Gives to Schaefer, goes to the basket on the baseline, cut off by Murphy. Outside, now to Schultz. Schultz in the lane, throws him a shot, no good. B. Pollock on the big board. And she's going to be fouled from behind by Schultz. And I believe Tatum Schultz just picked up
number four.
She hasn't scored a lot, if any, yet tonight, but she is definitely the floor general for Culver.
Absolutely. And the other side of that is Lady Zebras are in the free throw shooting bonus. And, you know, so you get a defensive rebound, you send them to the other end of the floor to shoot.
So B. Pollock on the line to shoot one of the bonus for Rochester. As Llewellyn will come back into the game, and Tatum Schultz will sit with four personal fouls.
Pretty much right now, the difference in the ball game is the free throw line for the Lady Zebras.
Which is?
Well, 3 points. I mean, they were 5 of 9.
Pollock's free throw rolls over the front of the rim and goes through.
That's the fifth straight free throw here in the fourth quarter, so they're 10 of 14. as opposed to four or five from Lady Cavs.
Pollock with one more from the free throw line, looking to push his lead to five. Second one, good again. 41-36, Rochester will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's Table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. Everyone needs calcium, and dairy products are the purest way to get your daily requirement. When shopping, load up on the perfect foods. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5:17 to play in the basketball game. Rochester leading now by five at 41-36. And after the Rochester timeout, the Culver Lady Cavaliers will have the basketball going to our left. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Full court press by the Lady Zebras. Llewellyn on the run. Culver with the numbers. Llewellyn right side of the floor. Cut off in the paint. Kicks it out to Hardy. Hardy now to Overmeyer. Sets up the offense to Llewellyn. 5:05 to play in the game. Rochester up 41-36. Schaefer against Holland. Outside to Overmeyer. Now to Zahner. To Llewellyn. Now the corner to Schaefer. Schaefer will fire a three over Holland. It's good again.
Automatic. That's 30-22 now for Schaefer.
4:45 to play in the game. Rochester up 41-39. Holland across the timeline against Schaefer in the double team. Cut off by the double team. Now gets it to B. Pollock on the right side.
And everything's
Pollock
a trap now.
To Murphy. Murph holds. Now works left side. Man-to-man defense by the Lady Cavaliers. Becky Malko at the free throw line. Bounce pass left side to Murphy. Murph a couple of dribbles. Now top to Riley Holland. 4:15 to play in the game. Riley backs it out of the timeline. We'll start over Rochester, who are up by two at 41-39. Malko against Zahner. Works around the defense. Stops in the lane. Out to Murphy. Now to Holland. And then she is... throws it in to Pfeiffer, and I believe Pfeiffer is going to be fouled by Harding. And Pfeiffer will go to back to the free throw line to shoot one of the bonus.
Yep, Harding will pick up her second.
So Riley Pfeiffer, the line to shoot one of the bonus for Rochester, leading 41-39. Riley's free throw on the way is good. One more coming for the 6-foot sophomore, looking to push this lead back to four. Again, with 4 minutes to play in the game. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Rochester High School, we are.
All the points for the Lady Z's this quarter coming from the free throw line.
Second one is good by Pfeiffer to make it 43-39.
They're 8 for 8 from the line.
You know what I like watching?
What
I like
watching
her dad, Eddie Pfeiffer, across the lane, have his hands buried in his hands, watching his daughter shoot free throws.
He's more entertaining than the ball game, huh?
I enjoy that.
Okay.
Culver with the basketball on the right side. And Llewellyn with the ball with 3:45 to play in the game. To Hardy, to Schaefer. Schaefer fakes a three, gives to Llewellyn. Now right side to Overmeyer. Really, there's only one score on the floor for Culver.
I was going to say, your turn's coming, Mus.
They're going to say Riley Holland knocked the basketball out of bounds. It'll stay with the Lady Cavs on the far side. Yeah, you're right. Tatum Schultz will come back in for Rochester. And now Culver will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
RTC's Fiber Connect is the leading scorer in the world of communications. Let RTC give you the safety of knowing you have touched down with a real winner when you sign up for cable television, high-speed internet, and telephone services. Don't pass this opportunity up and don't get blitzed by the competition. Cheer on the hometown team and call RTC at 223-2191 in Rochester or 598-2782 in Akron.
Call RTC in Rochester or Akron and become an eligible receiver for their winning Fiber Connect services. We'll be right back.
If you're stuck with high monthly car payments and think it's the best you can do, think again. By refinancing your car loan with State Farm Bank, you may save on your monthly payments and have more money to spend on other things. Call State Farm agent Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017 for more information. Jeff will help you see how much you could save by refinancing with State Farm Bank. That's Jeff Klinkhammer at 223-3017. State Farm Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3 minutes, 34 seconds to play in the game. The Lady Zebras leading 43-39. And after the Lady Cavalier timeout, each Rochester and Culver with three timeouts. Culver gets it inbounds. Schultz is back into the game with three personal, make that four personal fouls to Schaefer in the left corner. Schaefer back to Schultz. Back to Schaefer, left side. Schaefer, three on the way on the left side is short. And the rebound to Pollock. B then gives to Murphy. Rochester brings it up the floor, leading by four. 43-39. Murphy against Tatum Schultz. Back to Murphy from Hunter. Murph works left side. Got to get rid of it. Loses the handle. And fortunately for Rochester, that ball goes out of bounds because that was just about a five-second count applied by Schultz.
Yeah, I don't think Murphy was aware that they were even counting on her.
B. Pollock in the corner against Schaefer. And we're going to have a foul on Schaefer on the push. And that's going to send B. Pollock to the line to shoot two.
Schaefer picks up her third.
Minutes to play in the game. Rochester up 43-39. B. Pollock at the line to shoot two shots for her Lady Zebras.
You want to talk about quiet scoring. B. Pollock going for her 11 and 12 points of the game.
Val from the Rochester Sentinel gave us some scores. First one's good by B. Pollock. The Cast and Girls beat Pioneer tonight 32-19. And after the first quarter, Pioneer leads Cast in 10-2. The guys.
The boys.
What?
Yeah, the boys were supposed to be pretty good this year.
Who's
the
boys?
Castens.
Second one's no good, and Rayan Hunter comes over the back of Zahner, and that'll be, what, the team's fifth?
Yep. Hunter picks up her second.
3 minutes to play in the game. Rochester at 44-39, and Plymouth leads Triton after 120-8. Schultz runs the point, top of the key against Malco. High on the right side of Zahner. Zahner holds, now to Schaefer. Schaefer top of the key, back to Zahner behind the arc on the right wing, down to 2:45 to play in the game. Left side of Llewellyn. Now to Schultz, who doesn't shoot a whole lot, but she'll go to the basket, throws up a shot over Hunter, it's good! Lead is cut to three at 44-41 with 2.5 to play in the game. Three-quarter court press, Brad, here comes again.
Yeah, and it's going to work again.
And it turns it over to the Lady Zebras, ahead to Schaefer. Schaefer stops, pops, good!
Wow.
44-43, 2:20 to play in the game.
She was quiet in the third, but she's making up for it in the fourth.
Rochester up by one, and Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Why purchase a new or pre-owned vehicle from Mike Anderson? This is John Adair, General Manager, and after visiting with a satisfied customer, this is what they told me. I never felt pressured. I appreciated the salesperson's honest approach. He explained why we might want to consider a different vehicle than the one we originally thought I wanted. I was amazed at how easy it was to get financed, and my salesperson took the time to explain all the features of my car before I even drove off the lot. So the fact is, at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram Truck, we want every one of our customers to say, I love my car, after the sale. We mean it when we say, now you have a friend in the car business.
Seconds of play in regulation. Rochester leading 44-43. And after Rochester's timeout, they'll have the basketball on the far side. Right at midcourt. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman.
Kayla Schaefer for the Lady Cavs with 10 of her 24 points here in the fourth quarter.
She's the only one scoring.
Absolutely. Yeah.
She's the only one looking to score. Maybe Schultz once in a while, but that's it.
Yeah.
Riley Holland runs the point for Rochester.
All
1-2-2 zone.
All the ladies' East points in this quarter come from the free throw line.
Ball's loose. B. Pollock picks it up. loose again, and Rochester will take another timeout, and they're down to their final one. It's a 60-second timeout. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
The important message you're about to hear is brought to you by your Culligan man. Is your water hard to live with? Are you tired of water that tastes bad, smells bad, leaves brown stains, and a hard water buildup on your shower walls and faucets? Are you tired of dry skin, dull hair, and dingy laundry? How about replacing appliances prematurely? Well, it's time to do something about it. Your Culligan man has the answer, a water treatment system from Culligan that can eliminate these problems for only $9.95 a month for the first 6 months. Call 574-223-2420 today for details. 574-223-2420 or visit CulliganFultonCounty.com. Culligan, better water, pure and simple. Don't forget Culligan Salt Sale this Saturday morning. Cash and carry and save money too at Culligan, 5th and Madison, Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:03 to play in the game. Rochester clinging to a one-point lead right now at 44-43. Rochester has one timeout left. Culver with three. Rochester had the basketball right in front of their own bench going to our right. Tatum Schultz and Zahner in a little bit of foul situation. B. Pollock has three.
Yeah.
Murphy looks to get it in, does so to Riley Holland. Culver in a 2-3 zone.
Yep.
Riley has it down the right wing. Crossover dribble to the left side, gives to X. Alexa Holland with 1:50 to play in the game. Out to Riley Holland. Now to Murphy as Rochester looks to take some air out of the basketball. Hunter, bounce pass to Alexa Holland with 1:45.
Lady Cavs doing a good job pressuring the ball. They're not going to let them hold it.
Rand Hunter just about throws it away. Alexa Holland picks it up, gives to Murphy. A minute 30 to play in the game. Back to X, high on the left side. Over the defense to Murphy with a minute and 30. Now to Hunter. Rand, a couple of dribbles. Out to Murphy near the timeline of the minute 25. Murphy around Zahner. Picks up her dribble. And throws the ball away. Picked up by Schultz. Schultz is going to outrun Hunter to the rim. Shannon's ramp is good. Ball at 45-44, and they take a timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance Agency of Rochester, they know anything can happen at any given time without notice. They also know that finding the right insurance for the right price is really pretty easy. That's why they are your local trusted choice agent, which means they have access to multiple insurance companies that offer competitive pricing and coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street. You can also visit them online at SmithSawyerINS.com. Since 1932, Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance has protected individuals and families from those unforeseeable events in life.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
71 seconds to play in the game. Culver back up 45-44, and Rochester Basketball going to lead to the floor, and Culver Brand will be in a three-quarter court press.
Absolutely. It's worked for him tonight.
It has. You're right.
Yep. Look for the trap at mid-court.
Alexa Holland gives it back to Riley. A minute five to play. Back to X. Rochester has it across the timeline. Now they do with a minute two. Bounce pass near side to Alexa. Alexa now. Lob pass over the head to Riley Holland. Now to Murphy. Murph down low to wide open. Hunter jumper's good. Rochester back up 46-45. Rochester will take their final timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
When it comes to buying a home, you can draw on the experience of the mortgage lenders at First Federal Savings Bank. Since 1966, First Federal has provided financing to homeowners throughout the area. First Federal is locally owned, so loan approvals are made here and loan servicing is done in your hometown. Free pre-qualifications are available at First Federal Savings Bank, 301 East 9th in Rochester and 814 North US 35 in Winnemac. Offices are also in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka. First Federal is FDIC insured and an equal housing lender. Borrowers must meet underwriting guidelines and a delivery fee may be applied to the loan. NMLS 399927.
What would you do if they put you in power? Would you make toll roads free or use the express line when you have more than 15 items? How about lowering your gas prices? The BP Visa with Pump Rewards does just that. Use it virtually everywhere and you can save when you fill up. Apply today at BP.
Account subject to credit approval. Restrictions and limitations apply. BP Visa credit cards are issued by Chase Bank USA NA. See application located inside the station for pricing and rewards details. Purchases made at merchants where non-BP gasoline is sold do not earn rewards.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
58.2 seconds to play in the game. Rochester back up 46-45, and Rochester will apply a little man-to-man pressure in the backcourt, but not really.
Yep.
Schaefer will walk it up the floor for Culver. Crosses the timeline left. Now that's Schultz with 40. Tatum Schultz left side with 38. Works against Alexa Holland with 35. The back door is ball tipped away. Hardy picks it up and going out of bounds. Gives to Zahner. Down the lane to Schultz. Schultz in the pull-up jumper from 5 feet. It's no good off the mark. Deep Pollock on the rebound. And then we get somebody blew.
Oh, no. Lost a headgear.
Yep.
Ball
ran
out.
Header. Yep. Lost her headgear and gives Culver an opportunity to call timeout with 26 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up by one. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enert's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enyard's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enyard's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Paint in half the time with new paint and primer in one from Clark & Kensington. Available exclusively at Ace. You'll get top quality, easy-to-use paint and help that can only come from your neighborhood Ace. People who know their stuff will be right there to help you pick the perfect shade from Clark & Kensington's harmonious color palette, so you can get your weekend back with Clark and Kensington's paint and primer in one. Exclusively at Ace, the helpful place. You can find all of your Ace paints at Smith Farm Stores of Rochester and Plymouth.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
26.2 to play in the game. Rochester up 46-45, and after the turnover, Rochester has the basketball going to our right. Culver, not in the three-quarter court press. That is a full-blown man-to-man press.
Yep, full-court man-to-man.
Murphy will look to get it in. Murph studies. Does get it in, does so to Pollock, and B. Pollock is fouled by Schaefer, and Pollock will go to the other end to shoot two free throws with 25 seconds to play in the game.
It's four on Schaefer.
At last report, Winamac leading West Central. It was tied at 13 in that game, and now with 2 minutes left to play in the game, Winamac leading West Central 33-23. So B. Pollock with an opportunity to push this to a two-possession basketball game with two freebies here for Rochester. First on the way for the junior is in and out and back in. Ugh. 47. That's not right. It'll still be one possession.
Yeah. It's a three-pointer now. Yeah.
47-45 Rochester. One more for Pollock. The second one. Good again. 48-45 Rochester. Lady Zebras out of timeout. Culver has one. Llewellyn quickly with 20 seconds behind the arc. And now Culver will take their final timeout of the game. 20 seconds to play in the game. Rochester by three. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
New Holland T7000 Series tractors from New Holland Rochester take tractor performance to new heights with groundbreaking power, best-in-class hydraulics, and high-visibility horizon cab. These 135 to 180 PTO horsepower tractors offer the new fast steer turning option, a must-have feature for row crop or loader work. It lets you make a full right or left turn with only a 10-degree nudge of the steering wheel. Step up to a new level of performance with a New Holland T7000 tractor from New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South.
Terrorist attacks, war, floods, and tornadoes. Our lives have always had to confront major catastrophic events. Christians accept the fact that these events happen and talk about them with Jesus Christ. We also share the positive things that happen when one of the advantages of knowing Jesus as your personal Savior. Find out more about this by attending one of our services at Grace United Methodist Church on Saturday at 5:30 p.m. and Sunday at 9:30 a.m. Our church is located at the corner of 7th and Jefferson Streets in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
20.5 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up 48-45. It'll be Culver basketball.
And watch for multiple picks to get Schaefer
open. Absolutely. They're at the volleyball line trying to get this one in across the way. Overmeyer gets it into Schultz. Schultz behind the arc with 18. Backs it out, sets it at the offensive 17. I'd foul. Why don't you foul?
They're double teaming the ball.
Schultz out to Schaefer with 10. Schaefer with 9. Dribbles around looking for a shot. Throws up a prayer off the glass. It goes.
Let the two go.
Number 50.
They don't have to inbound it. Rochester doesn't have to inbound it, but they do. And Hunter is fouled with 0.2 to play in the game. They did not need to inbound the ball. 48-47. Rochester on top, and Hunter will go to the line to shoot two for her Lady Zebras. Zahner has picked up a personal foul. That's her fourth. And Rand Hunter will go to the line to shoot two shots for Rochester, who lead 48-47. This one, I mean, you can't
catch and shoot in .2.
Free throw for Hunter is no good. She'll have one more, but it doesn't matter.
Now the clock went to zero.
Yeah. I think a scorekeeper thought it was a 1-1. It's two shots, and it should be .2 on the clock. 48-47 Rochester, looking to reset the clock at .2 seconds. Ray and Hunter will have one more free throw for the Lady Zebras, who are leading by one. And there's .2 to play in the game. Rayanne Hunter will have one more free throw. And Rayanne Hunter with one more. Might be better off if they just missed this one.
Yeah.
Hunter's second one. No good. Rebound. That'll do it. The Rochester Lady Zebras hold on to beat 5-1 Culver by the final of 48-47. Post-game thoughts into this on 82.1 WROI.